forgiveness is not only for the perpetrator. Forgiveness also for the victims, because to me, forgiveness is something that you let go the anger, the pity from your heart, and the space becomes available. Once you let the anger go, you can fill that blank space with a lot of peace and love. And forgiveness is something that once you forgive someone, you feel lighter, you feel peace in your heart. And it's a healthy thing, because you don't have to think about somebody hurt you and they cause some anger, and you've been carrying this anger since you were hurt. It's kind of like carrying a negative energy. It's kind of like carrying a backpack full of load. Every single day you're carrying this load in your shoulder. And once you forgive, you feel that that load is gone. The backpack, you drop the backpack, and you'll you'll feel peace and love in your heart. And that is very positive. This is very also healthy. That will help you to move on, and you will not feel that negative energy in your mind. So so forgiveness is not only for the perpetrators, for also for the victims, and it helps to move on. It also helps to deal with the trauma and the painful, pain and sufferings the victims go through. So I think, it's good, if people can forgive, because that is really, something very healthy. And, but forgiveness doesn't mean that, you forgive and then, you also want revenge at the same time, because you forgive someone not because of they did something good to you. They did something bad to you. They hurt you. That's why the point of forgiveness comes in your mind. And God also loves the people, more those who can forgive easily. So you are definitely on a moral high ground, if you can, come up with that stage and show some mercy to someone who were not as good as you, and and because of that they hurt you, and they never realized that how bad they might realize how bad they did to you. But once you forgive, I think it not only helps you, it also helps to move on. It also helps the cycle of hate and violence at that point, because I think it's good for everyone that if you can forgive and move on. Forgiveness is not a process. It comes in your mind like this, it's a process. I mean, you learn and you have to practice. You cannot just forgive someone boom like that way. It has to be in your system. And the earlier in our life we learn this is better for us, because it's easy to raise a good kid than fix a broken man. I don't know, some famous person said this thing. I don't remember the name, but which is absolutely true, that you can easily raise a good kid with all these good qualities, rather than raising a kid with negative qualities and then later on try to fix him. It's harder. So like I said, that it's better if the process starts earlier in our life, in our childhood. In my case, the peace and forgiveness was taught to me in my very early stage. And I mentioned also yesterday that I learned, the first thing I learned, the first human history of forgiveness I learned from a beggar in my birth country. And then later on, my parents also told us a lot of stories about human stories about peace and forgiveness. So it was in my system from my childhood. And so when I was in a situation like this, that I was shot, and now I was in a situation that now should I forgive him or should I just ask for revenge? So because of my upbringings and also my Islamic faith teaches that forgiveness is the best policy. So I choose the path of forgiveness, and I forgive him right away after I got my life back. But then it took several years, because I had to go through a healing process. And when I grew mentally, psychologically, and spiritually, because time is such an important factor. Time gives you the best answer. Time can help you to do the best judgment. But if we strike, or if we try to give a response right away, most likely, you know, we'll make a mistake because we are hard, you know, at the time of the event, and we may make mistakes. But if you take time, we'll definitely be able to do a better, you know, make a better decision and to, you know, give a best response. So in my case, I forgave after I got my life back, but it took time because of the healing process. And then in course of time, I realized that, yes, I forgave him, but it's not going to bring any, you know, anything good to society. It's not going to bring anything positive, because this guy, he's waiting for execution, but my forgiveness did not make any difference. Yes, I forgave him, but it's not bringing any good solution to society. And I also mentioned yesterday that forgiveness is not just you forgive and then you move on. Forgiveness means you forgive yourself first, to forgive someone and to move on. Then you forgive, you know, your perpetrator. And then the next step is, you know, have a mediation dialogue to understand that how that event happened, how we could have prevented that. And moving forward, what can we do so that it doesn't happen anymore? So that was, you know, that is the three step of forgiveness. And you know, it was in my system from a very early stage. So I could do it easily, I forgave, but the next part, it took time, you know, to come up to that stage to run a campaign to save his life.